Hey there guys, so yesterday me and my friends went to see Spider-Man No Way Home in Cineworld at Eastbourne, and this was one of my most anticipated films of the year. And I gotta say, it's so disappointing. It's just fan service. I'm only joking. Like, to me, this is my favourite MCU Spider-Man film and probably Tom Holland's best performance to date. Marvel, Sony, Kevin Feige, John Watts found a way to make this the darkest Spider-Man film yet, but somehow make it funny and such a crowd pleaser. And this is the worst kept secret in Hollywood, but it does add some kind of closure to the Sam Raimi films and the Mark Webb films. And this is a guy who wasn't a big fan of the Andrew Garfield era, but after watching this, it makes you want to look back on it and be like, yeah, that was fun. There is one small cameo at the beginning of the film, and I was just so happy. I was just like, thank you, Marvel, so much. There is fan service in this movie, and yes, it can be a good thing or a bad thing, but the film doesn't rely on it all that much. I mean, there's other stuff that's going on that plays an important part to Tom Holland's Spider-Man's depth and the sacrifices he makes. Bringing back previous villains from other Spider-Man films worked. I mean, for argument's sake, you could say the Lizard and the Sandman are just bench warmers, but I was okay with them in this movie. They were fine. William Dafoe adds a new layer to Green Goblin. Alfred Molina as Doc Ock, just he is so much more than the trailers give. And Jamie Foxx is Electro. This version is so much better. They redeem the character, and now I really want a Spider-Man movie with this version of Jamie Foxx's Electro now. And of course, the worst kept secret in Hollywood, Tobey Maguire and Andrew Garfield are in this movie, and they are great. I mean, Tobey Maguire is my favourite Spider-Man. I mean, I grew up on him back in the early noughties, and he deserved a fourth film. So does Andrew Garfield. He deserved a third film. But their interaction with one another is just gold. There's like one scene, there's like 2 minutes of the film when they're just talking about Spider-Man stuff and comparing the differences. And I wish that was the entire film, because that would have just been great, but this is just as great. But just seeing Tobey Maguire, Andrew Garfield and Tom Holland Spider-Man comparing differences and working out like, oh, one is organic web, and comparing, oh, you fought an alien? Oh, all I fought was a Russian guy in a rhino suit. It's just great. The way the film ends and Tom Holland's betrayal in this film, by the end of the film, I was saying to myself, Tom Holland is Spider-Man. And I know what you're thinking, don't you consider him Spider-Man in the other films? I consider him more to be like Iron Man Jr. And in this film, there isn't a MCU character watching over him, holding his hand. I mean, Doctor Strange is in this movie, of course, but like Spider-Man kicks his ass by using maps, which was great. And we forget that Spider-Man is a kid. He can make easy mistakes. The way the film ends just wraps up the high school trilogy nicely, and possibly the Avengers era for Spider-Man as well. But it also sets up a what to come for the Warcrawler. And he goes back to the basics. He's no longer Iron Man Jr. There were some like pacing issues here and there, but nothing really distracting. Also, we could have had one more villain just to make up the Sinister Six, but I think 5 villains were more than just enough. Overall, Spider-Man No Way Home could have failed in so many ways, but somehow it ended up being my third favourite Spider-Man film of all time. It's everything you want in a Spider-Man movie, and then some. It's a 9 out of 10 for me, and this is Tom Holland's best performance of his career to date. Thank you so much for watching this video, guys. Go like, share and subscribe. Let me know, what did you think of Spider-Man No Way Home? Go check out my Facebook, my Twitter and my Instagram page. You guys are awesome. I've got your back.